Welcome back. I'm so excited because today is the day. Today is the day that we'll be opening my brand new iPad Pro, fourth generation. My newest iPad, I also got with it the Magic Keyboard and a writing pencil. I did not get the Apple Pencil. I tried to buy myself a good one that was cheaper and had good reviews on Amazon so I could save myself a couple of bucks. See if that works or not, but first we're gonna open the iPad and the Magic Keyboard. I'm gonna try it out and give like a review after I kind of like use it for today. I'm kind of worried. I ordered it and it's supposed to be a replacement for my laptop. Here's everything that I got. I got the 12.9 inch. I got the Magic Keyboard and I got the Jam Jig stylus pen. I'm so excited. Obviously, first we're gonna open the iPad. Everything ready? This is about to be really satisfying. Pick it up later. I'll shake it out. I will leave links to where I got these items in the description. Here it is.
She's beefy.
This is my head, and then this is the size of it. It's like, okay, here we go. I'm so excited to use this right now. That's a big screen. It's honestly very big. No home button. It's gonna take some getting used to. So I'm gonna turn it on, try to show you. There she is. Like, it's kind of like I'm holding a computer screen in my hand without the laptop part. Pretty big. Hello. It already has 86% battery, which is nice. Okay, we're gonna set it up now. So swipe up to open. English, United States, quick start. So basically you can like use your phone to set it up, which is really nice. Oh, and see, it already popped up on my phone. Activating my iPad right now. Okay, so my iPad is all set up. Here it is. This is what it looks like. It looks really cool. I really like it so far. It's very sleek looking. The box comes with just the iPad, a little like instruction sheet, and then the charger. Next, we're gonna open the Magic Keyboard. It feels really heavy. Like, it feels like a good, like, probably like
6 pounder. I don't know.
How do I open this? Oh. Like I said, I'll pick it up later. Okay, here she is. She has a cute little Apple symbol on there and the place for the camera. I'm gonna take this off. Oh, hello. I've seen reviews on this and it doesn't necessarily like go all the way back. Like this part does. It's cool because there's a charging port right here so you don't have to take your iPad off to charge it. And you can charge it through the case, which is really convenient. It goes back like this so that kind of the iPad kind of flipped. Stick it on, and there we are. It is actually pretty heavy, but that way it won't like, it probably won't be like top heavy then. Like when you put it on your lap, for example, and like type. See, it's not falling off my lap. It's just sitting on my lap right now, and it's not. So then you just push it back, and then you can adjust it like this. I can see the keys kind of lighting up the keyboard. You can swipe up. Yes. Swipe up. Oh, I said you. Ready? Swipe up. That's not what I wanted. This is very sleek and it feels like a computer actually. It's very nice. I like it so far. It's crazy how strong this magnet is. It's not going anywhere. I'm literally shaking it as hard as I can. It's not going anywhere. You can just like take the iPad right off whenever you want. And then it becomes an iPad again. Last but not least, I want to open this stylus pen and see if it actually is compatible with iPad. Okay, this is what it looks like. It comes with an extra tip. If you were expecting the Apple Pencil, I'm sorry, but you know, your girl's kind of broke. It comes with this really nice, like, duster thing, maybe for the iPad itself. There's a little thing right there, and then this goes in there, and you charge it like that.
It works.
No way. This is... Folks, I found a loophole. Okay, so here's just me playing on my iPad, trying to figure out how to edit for the first time, you know. So as I was playing with the iPad, I played on it for a good 2 hours probably, and it started at 86% battery life and it went down to like 27, which isn't bad for playing on it for 2 hours straight. Here's a couple other views of the iPad. The swiping motions and like all the motions that you use were basically what you use with any iPhone or any like Apple product, and I like it because the screen's very big. You can really see what you're doing. Very smooth movements, very sleek. And those are a couple of the apps I use to edit, if you were wondering. Here you can just see me putting the iPad on the Magic Keyboard and it lights up. And then with the trackpad, it's very smooth and it feels just like a regular MacBook trackpad. And what's nice is when the cursor goes over an app, it lights it up, so it's really easy to see what you're selecting. I think that's a really cool detail that they put in there. Here's a couple shots of me drawing badly with a pencil that I got. It's pretty smooth actually, and for $40, it probably works just as good as the Apple Pencil does. I didn't see any problems with it so far. If you like to draw and are thinking about using the iPad Pro to draw, I would recommend the app Procreate, which is what I'm using here. I'm so stoked that I bought this stuff. I'm really excited about it. If you were like thinking about it or weren't sure, I would definitely go for it because so far I've loved it. It takes some getting used to. It's not like a regular laptop and it's a lot different. The commands are different for sure, but it's well worth it, I think. If you guys wanna invest in the Magic Keyboard, I would definitely do that too. It's been very nice for me to just sit here and like tilt it any way I want. I've been using it for the past couple hours and I kind of lost track of time because it's just fun to play with. It's fun to get used to actually. So if you wanted to get one of these, I highly recommend it. Instead of the Apple Pencil, here is the box and the brand name and all that. It's very, very good to me so far. Nothing wrong with it, and it already comes with an extra tip, which I don't know if Apple Pencils do or not. I can't say, but I don't think they do. All you have to do is charge it, plug it in at night, and in the morning you'll have it ready to go. It shuts off on its own. All you do is tap it and a little blue light will come on. Yep, like that. Just tap it to turn it off. And it's off. And it's literally so easy to use. It's basically the Apple Pencil, but cheaper. I went on Amazon and I checked all the reviews, and this was the one. I will link that in the description. I will link where I got the iPad in the description, and I will link the Magic Keyboard in the description as well. If you like this video, please comment and like and subscribe. I might do a vlog soon. I don't know yet. I haven't thought about it. And I'm gonna play it on my iPad now. It's like okay, bye.